So you admit to shooting your commanding officer under the direction of a Russian agent, is that correct? So unless you have something else significant to share with us, Sergeant, this investigation is over. You have been played. It's the Russians.
Oh, it's Solomon. Haven't you listened to anything I've been saying?
You want us to believe that there's a PLR threat and Solomon's at the head?
Yes.
To believe that you acted in the best interests of our nation when you let a Russian agent go and shot your own man. But we can't. Nothing can be corroborated.
This is insane.
No one can verify the third nuke even exists.
The bank collapsed. Al Bashir's dead. Your unit is dead. Dimas presumed dead. Kafarov's dead. 80,000 French people are actually dead.
Those are all your witnesses, Sergeant.
The only thing we can say happened for sure is you fragged your CO.
Bring him in.
You saw this man shoot his commanding officer, right?
Just knock off the bullshit, Sergeant. Didn't Dima set you up? Didn't he talk you into shooting Cole and then escape to Paris where he triggered the nuke? Wasn't that Dima?
Solomon has the nuke.
Solomon is one of ours. He is an overseas asset, and he has been for years. We put him next to Al Bashir for information.
You are shitting me. He's a murderer. You saw the video.
Well, you get the good with the bad when it comes to assets, and sometimes sacrifices must be made for the greater good.
Isn't that your angle?
Jesus Christ. The nuke is still out there. Solomon's still out there. You can't just walk away from the threat.
You might be right, Sergeant. Maybe Solomon was too close to the fire, but I assure you we are on top of this situation. The Russians are a clear and present threat. Yes. What do you mean you lost a train?
Solomon's using the PLR.
He is an overseas asset, and he has been for years.
He used me, and he uses everyone. He said, get the bombs.
80,000 dead.
We can avert war between our nations.
Well, the blast yield matches Russian suitcase nuke specs.
We've secured what appears to be a WMD.
Wait, there's room for two more.
How many portable nuclear devices did you see in the bank vault?
Where the hell are the other two?
The 14th of this month.
We got maps of Paris, New York.
He's using public transit to move the weapons.
Suleiman will strike!
Train map inside the bank vault. Uh-huh. What was the time written on it?
6:02. Why?
Dave, you trust me? All right, follow my lead.
It's getting dramatic now. Yeah, this is blending in with the first mission. He gets a gun? How come I don't get a gun? I guess I'm just gonna follow him. Jump out the window, hell yeah. That's kind of a dramatic way to jump out the window, don't you?
Come on, move it!
It's time to go. Where do I lose him? Because he wasn't in the first one. The first mission. There's the train. Screw it, I got places to be, man. This looks familiar, doesn't it? This looks a little bit familiar. I get to replay this now, minus the slow motion. And with a UMP. This doesn't match the beginning at all. I don't have time for your nonsense.
Innocent, no one. Everyone.
So now we get to see what happens at the end, do we? Or do we not? I don't know. Okay. He already put the bomb out there. That he put it on there before he even did anything. That's not cool. I still don't know how he misses that. That's a little silly that he misses that. Freaking point blank. Doo-doo-doo. And it's giving me the tutorial on how to move, which is interesting. They're already there. Excuse me. The freaking triggers don't seem to be working properly. I do not have time for your nonsense. There's a nuke and I'm on a train. Excuse me while I reload while there's a nuke on a train. Is there anyone else in here? There's the bombs, and this is the room where we get jumped. Shoot him. You should have shot him.
Are you alone?
Huh? No, I'm
who
not.
Who are you with? Huh?
Well, technically I am alone, actually. Don't do it, bro.
Good, you are good. What's next? I'm not afraid to die. How about you?
I'm not apparently afraid to die. I apparently do not give a damn. Okay.
In there! Go, go! Otrop, Otrop! You, hold him back!
You are not holding me back, bro. Because you are too slow. Where did he go? Oh, Jesus Christ. You can't stop me, bro. You can't stop me. I'm coming for you. Which way did he go? This way? I guess this way is the only way to go. Ow. Climb. Whoa, glitch there.
He must not get the bomb.
I'm coming for you. You'd think this many people would have some sort of competence and be capable of stopping a person, but nope, I'm just that badass. Excuse me. I'd like to climb? I'm not climbing. I'm going this way. Or am I? I'm going the other way, aren't I? Nope. Okay, whatever. I'm going up. It's apparently nighttime as well. He's in the car.
Don't ask. Get in.
How?
Come on, they're getting away.
He get a
police
freaking
talking about armed men in Times Square. It's gotta be the PLR. Buckle up.
Where did you get a police car, bro? We are totally screwed with you driving this thing. Jesus Christ. Am I trying to shoot his tires out? Cause. Okay, we'll just do that. Jesus Christ, man. Is that Montez, by the way? I'm pretty sure that's Montez. He's just such a badass, I'm telling you.
He's coming, bro. He's coming! He's coming!
Everything freaking...
No! Who dies first?
You'll never win!
Well, he's dead. You're out of ammo. And now you're handcuffed to me. That's gonna make this awkward, isn't it? Fighting hand. Everyone's just sitting there watching, too. It's fantastic. Hey, look, you're choking yourself. How's that working for you? They're still sitting there watching. There's a guy in military uniform being beaten on by someone, and they're just sitting there watching. Someone gonna help? No one's gonna help? Is that the nuke right there? That's a way to kill someone right there. It's a nuke. It is indeed a nuke. Do we win? Do I get a cookie? Do I get arrested again?
Radiation is like life. A uniquely damaging event. Perhaps I will live another 30 years. Perhaps I will die tomorrow. I am telling my story here. The story of how Solomon used power-hungry men like Al-Bashir and Kafarov to set fire to the world. And the American Marine, who, like me, chose the hardest path of all.
That's Dima, isn't it?
But I have no regrets. I have always served Russia, trying to make a difference. Sometimes I was forced to make difficult choices. Many lives have been saved. Many have been lost. I am certain Moscow does not view it in the same light as I do. But enough is enough. As Vladimir would say, you can only die once. Make sure it is worth it.